you remember those times? 3 days of fasting. Seven days, 21 days of fasting. 40 days of fasting in the past. To hear the voice of the Lord.
To
know if the decision I'm making is correct. Have you forgotten? Because we knew all the desires of the child of God should come from heaven. It is the Lord who ruled over us. It is the Lord who helped us go forward. There was a day when we would find pastors and ask for directions. The servants of God had the word of the Lord in their lips at that time. They were not ruled by their own intelligence. It was not the Bible college's degrees that guided them. It was not the language styles that led them. It was not money that led them. They were filled with the Spirit and speak, thus says the Lord. The people in the church would say what the Lord wanted. We had a good time. We had such a beautiful time in the past. We had anointed people in the past. But now who is ruling us? What is ruling us now? How do we make our decisions today? How do we make each of our decisions? Money makes our decisions. Influence makes our decisions for us. With competition with others, we make certain decisions. If they can do that, why can't I do it? We make decisions as our heart desires. Look into the spiritual world. How is the decision taking place? No one has time to fast. No one has time to pray. Who has the perseverance to sit in the presence of the Lord? Everyone is busy and busy. No one has the time to sit in the presence of the Lord and tarry. Instead they trust in their own intelligence. With pain, let me say, the spiritual realm is also trusting in intelligence. Apostle Paul, in 1 Corinthians, as he rebukes, is there not intelligent people among you should be judging the world? You should be judging angels. It is a shameful thing for you to take your quarrelings to the court system. Anointed one, can you not have the chutzpah to make a decision? If there's a problem in your family,
counseling
it is good to have counseling. It is good to have
counselors.
If you don't have time to sit on your knees, what spirit are you led by? Without getting anointed, if you just study the books of this world, are you not ashamed to go to a worldly counselor? To make the decision of the church. Are we not ashamed to go to the courts that will make a decision based on money? Who are we led by? Who makes our decisions for us? Everything is a democracy. How do we know if something is correct or wrong? It's majority rule. Two out of three. Or 51% is another way. More people raise their hands. That is how decisions are made in the spiritual world. Even if the word of God is with the minority, no one is willing to accept that. Yes, we need someone to rule and decisions to make. Oh, I accept the decisions of the majority. Oh, but a child of God's spiritual walk, it is not for a vote. It is not decided by the majority. Oh, we heard a minute before. Oh, when 5,000 were fed by the bread, only 12 people would stand for the word. A small group will always stand as a remnant for the Lord. When the Holy Spirit came down, the world was turned upside down, not by the 5,000 but the 12. Oh, if there's one person anointed,
a
majority rule does not matter.
You can turn this world upside down because of the anointing that God has given you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can turn the world upside down by God's anointing. Oh, you can turn darkness upside down. Oh, the powers of the city can be turned. Oh, to rebuke the powers of darkness. The Lord has given the power to his anointed.
Hallelujah.
But the church should be led by the Spirit. In Acts chapter 9, we are familiar with that. Verse
31.
And all the churches in Judea, Samaria had peace. What happened? They were increasing. They were growing in the fear and the favor of the Lord. And it says that they were in the comfort of the Holy Ghost. The church is a growing church. How did they walk? Oh, they were walking by the word of the Holy Spirit. Oh, even if there's no one in the church, more leaders are there. Even if it's in Judea, in Galilee, or in Samaria, or in America, or in India,
Middle East, Australia.
The church should be led by the comforting of the Holy Spirit. How many of you will praise him?
Let the church walk in the comfort of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. Let the church walk in the comfort of the Holy Spirit. Let the church be led by the Holy Spirit. Oh, bride church. Oh, church that is the body of Christ. The church, the child that is brought by the blood of the
Lamb.
Oh, church that is prepared by the Holy Spirit. How many of you are
I rejoice in the presence of God.
Oh, the church should only be led by the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
In Acts chapter
13,
the Antiochian church, it was filled with the Holy Spirit. Oh, the servants of God were filled. It was filled with prophets. One day the Holy Spirit said, I want two people from the church, Barnabas and Paul. I have seen them for the ministry. Send them. The Holy Spirit said,
കേൾക്കണം സഭ
and the church obeyed the holy spirit
ഇന്ന് പകൽക്കാലം സഭയോട് ആത്മാവ് ഒരു ദൂത് പറഞ്ഞാൽ
oh if the church is talked by the holy spirit
അതിനെ ഭൂരിപക്ഷം നോക്കരുത്
oh don't look at the majority
എത്ര പേര് കൂടെ നിൽക്കും നോക്കരുത്
don't look who is with you
ആത്മാവ് പറഞ്ഞാൽ yield to the voice of the holy spirit
yield to the voice of the holy spirit
പരിശുദ്ധ ആത്മാവിന് വിധേയപ്പെട്ടോണം ദൈവസഭ
yield to the voice of the holy spirit
ദൈവസഭ ആത്മാവിൽ നയിക്കപ്പെടണം
the church should be led by the holy spirit
ദൈവദാസന്മാർ ആത്മാവിൽ നയിക്കപ്പെടണം
the servants of god should be led by the holy spirit
പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവ് പറയുന്ന പോലെ നടക്കണം
walk the way the holy spirit